Now we are going to discuss about the diffraction through the crystal, that how that particular crystal is identifying. So what is diffraction? The light rays when passes through a sharp edge of an object can form some bright region inside the geometrical shadow of the object. This is due to the bending nature of the light called the diffraction. So what is that diffraction mean? That means when a light source is passing through an object at the sharp edge, the region inside the geometric shadow of the object start brightening and showing the particular diffraction, the bending of that, this is happened due to the bending of that particular light. So what are the main criteria for diffraction? The thickness of the obstacle or slit is of the order of incident light wavelength. The diffraction in crystal, that is the year 1912, a German physicist Lau suggested that the three-dimensional arrangement of atom in a crystal can produce diffraction. But with which radiation? So that radiations can be taken by this particular X-ray diffraction in the crystal. So we will discuss the X-ray diffraction method, how that particular X-ray diffraction is taking place. So the wavelength of the X-rays is of the order of angstrom, which is in the range of spacing between the atoms in crystal, hence it produces the diffraction. So the importance of the X-ray, we need to identify, as you can see, which type of X-ray photon energy and the wavelength energy we are utilizing to examine the internal structure of various materials. So as you can see, there are the various conditions, there are the various parameters which is showing and that are utilizing for the X-ray crystallography, that is 10 kV EBW, and it is same for the mammography and the medical CT scan, that is 100 kV, and the airport security also using that particular scanning intensity of the X-ray. So how it produces the X-ray? A typical X-ray tube that is showing here, the X-ray are produced whenever the high-speed electron diode collide with the metal target, that the particular electron is collide with the metal target, and the source of electron, hot W filament, a high accelerating voltage between the cathode and the anode, that due to that particular high temperature, high voltage filament accelerated, and the main target, metal targeted by this particular, the copper aluminium MOMG works as anode. So what are the Bragg's law in one dimension? N is lambda, that is the 2D sine theta. So English physicist Sir W.H. Bragg and his son W.L. Bragg developed a relationship in 1913 to explain why the cleavage faces of crystal appear to reflect X-ray beam at certain angle of incident theta. The variable d is the distance between the atomic layer in the crystal, and the variable lambda is the wavelength of the incident X-ray beam and is an integer. So this observation is an example of X-ray wave interference, commonly known as X-ray diffraction, XRD method, and was direct evidence for the periodic atomic structure of crystal, which are postulated for several centuries. So how this particular, before moving that, how that particular interface, we will need to define it. There are the two types of wave, that is the constructive and the destructive. As you can see, there are the propagation in the direction and the amplitude, that is showing the propagation, the constructive interference and the destructive interference. As you can see in this, there are the difference between that particular. So these are the constructive and destructive interface wavelength waves, and the derivation of the Bragg's law, n lambda is equal to 2d sine theta, that one X-ray is touching the upper surface and the second X-ray going to the bottom one. So the constructive interference, that particular constructive interference is defining by this particular graphs, and this is the destructive one. That combining both by that is in the constructive interface, in the in phase, and the destructive one or the outer phase. So how it works, that is, the occur only the part difference, that is L lambda is equal to AB plus BC, that is AB is equal to BC. So L lambda is equal to 2AB sine theta, that particular 2AB, that ABC is defining by that particular. So d sine theta is equal to d sine theta L lambda, and that is equal to 2D sine theta, that D is the difference between that. So lambda is equal to 2D HKL sine theta HKL. So these are the various problem which is related to the X-ray beam. And there is another X-ray diffraction method. So these are the just basic differential deriving of that particular, that is how it is simple, the derivation of this particular X-ray, the Bragg's law for the X-ray diffraction. So X-ray diffraction method are divided by these particular methods, the Lau method, powder method, and the rotating crystal method. So what is the Lau method? The Lau method is the first diffraction method ever used for the structural study. It was demonstrated by the von Lau. We can use this method for identification of any orientation present in the single crystal. And this is the quantity of the single crystal can also be checked with this method. In this method, the single crystal is fixed at a particular position and the diffraction angle is fixed. The continuous spectrum of radiation from X-ray tube will be used in this particular method, that is the polychromatic beam, and each set of the plane diffract out particular wavelength with satisfy Bragg's law for a given value of B and theta. So the two category, back reflection method, transmission method. So there is the transmission method. As you can see, the X-ray which is going to the collimator and focusing on the single crystal, that a refraction is taking place, and that is defining by this particular. So as you can see, so this is how this particular transmission method is to be taking place. This is the another mode of finding that particular transmission method, the back refraction method. So the position of the spot on the film depend on the orientation of the single crystal related to the incident beam. And the spot are distorted or smeared out if the crystal is bent or twisted. With these two, we can analyze the quality and orientation of the crystal. And there is another method, the rotating crystal method. A single crystal is used in this method. It is mounted with one of its axes normal to the monochromatic X-ray beam. A cylindrical film is placed around it, and the crystal is rotating like this. This is the particular cylindrical, and the crystal is rotating in it about the chosen axis. As the crystal rotates, the set of lattice plane will at some point make the correct Bragg angle for the monochromatic incident beam. And at that point, a diffracted beam will be informed. The reflected beam are located on the surface of the imaginary cones, obviously, and the shape and size of the unit cell, as well as the arrangement of the atom, the crystal structure of unknown material inside the cell, can determine with the help of this method. So this is the particular shape and size identification of the unit cell, can be identified this type of method, the rotating crystal method. Now next is the powder method, a very fine powder sample which is used instead of single crystal, that you can see in this particular crystal. So this powder sample is assembly of tiny crystal oriented in random direction with respect to the incident beam, monochromatic X-ray. The diffraction will come from all set of plane present in the powder, as you can see in this particular figure. The diffraction coming from all set plane of the present in the powder sample. The Debye Schaeffer camera method, that is utilizing a small amount of powder material, is sealed into a fine capillary tube made from the glass that does not diffract X-ray. That is the particular, that the tube, these are the tubes. For a sample, okay, so the powder diffraction diffract the X-ray. So the sample is placed in the Debye Schaeffer camera, as is accurately aligned to be in the center of the camera, so the X-ray enters the camera through the collimometer. That particular the powder diffracts the X-ray in accordance with Bragg's law to produce cone of diffracted beam. That particular things, that is the cones are diffracted beam are reflecting on that. So these cone intersect a strip of a photography. As you can see, it's a kind of a sound wave. Film located in the cylindrical film, that is the like a X-ray film, that is the particular work is working on, and the cylindrical camera to produce a corrected set of arc on the film. When the film is removed from the camera, flattered and poses, it is shown the diffraction line and the hole for the incident and the transmitted beam. As you can see, this is the result one. So for a sample of several randomly oriented single crystal, the diffracted beam will lie on the surface of several cones. As you can see, this particular thing is happening. And the cone may emerge in all direction, forward and backward. So in case of powdered sample, the diffracted beam form continuous cone. A circular film is used to record the diffraction pattern. Each cone intersect the film, giving the diffraction line. And this line are seen as arc on the film. So the determination of this lattice parameter by this application of XRD. So as you can see in this particular film, we can find out that S1, S2 and that is the W. By knowing the HPL value, one can easily calculate the lattice parameter of the cubic crystal, that is the theta is equal to pi S1 2W. The theta is equal to pi 2, 1 minus S2 by W. So we can simplify that by identifying sine square theta is equal to lambda square by divided by 4a square, and that is h square, l, hk square and l square plus. So what are the techniques where this X-ray technique is to be used? That is used to distinguish between the crystalline that amorphous material, that determine the structure of the crystalline material, that determine the determination of the electron distribution within the atom and the throughout the unit cell. It also determination of the orientation of the single crystal. X-ray diffraction method as well determination of the texture of the polygrain material and that measurement of the strain and small grain size, etc. So this is X-ray diffraction method are utilizing to identify the various crystalline structures and their orientations and their textures, their distribution. So that is how we can examine by this particular X-ray diffraction method. So what are the advantages of that X-ray diffraction? These X-ray diffraction method is a non-destructive testing, and the X-rays are the least expensive, the most convenient and the most widely used method to determine crystal structure. X-rays are not absorbed very much by air, so the sample need to be evacuated in an evacuated chamber. The disadvantage is also it will not interact very strongly with the lighter element. So these are the basically advantage and disadvantage and where it is utilizing to find out. These are the details of this particular X-ray diffraction method. And these are the various problems to calculate the various the volume of the that is the you can have the atomic radius and the chromium and the BCC structure. So calculate the volume of the unit cell, the lithium and the BCC structure to calculate the respectively and so on. This you need to calculate all these by this particular methods. So there are the various kind of particular examples or problem to find out for the practice. So by this you can note down all this and you can clear out this to clear the concept of this X-ray diffraction and the other methods. So for this, I am holding this lecture. Thank you.